In this video, you will get familiar with the concept and types of loops in RPA Express. We will also see an example of using for each loop with a list variable. Loops are used to repeat the group of actions that are nestled inside the loop. Repeat loop will repeat all actions for a defined number of times. While loop until a certain condition is met. For example, until the result of wait for image action becomes true. Retry loop will try to repeat the actions for a defined maximum number of times until the actions are executed successfully. For each loop will iterate through a list and table variable and performs the same group of actions for each or for several values stored in it. For example, open all URLs in a list. Using loops allows to make scripts robust and simple. Let's see how to use for each loop with a list variable by automating a small use case. The robot will read a list of currency codes from column A in an Excel file, get the conversion rate of each currency into US dollars, and store it in column B in the same file. First, we will open the Excel file with the currency codes and save the first column in a list variable codes using getColumn action. We will later save the conversion rates in column B of this file, so we will use setCellValue action to set the name of the column to cell B1. Then we will use forEach loop to iterate through the list of currency codes. The first value in the list is the name of column, so we will set a filter to start with the second value and end with the last value in the list. For each value, the bot will open the website and set the currency to convert. We will click the button to close the cookies pop-up. We will use a mouse click on XPath for this, and we'll provide the XPath of the button. We need to click the button only once when we open the website for the first time, so we will put the mouse click in the exception handling action so the execution doesn't fail when we open the website for the second and other times. We will use web element action with the parameter setValue to set the currency. The value will be taken from the variable element, which will store the currency code in each iteration. We need to provide the XPath of the dropdown. We need to copy the XPath of the input element. We'll press Tab to select the currency. In the second drop-down field, we always need to set value USD. We will use another web element action. Create a special string variable with value USD. Select it in the drop-down. And provide the XPath of this web element. Press Tab to select the currency and Enter to convert. Then we can save the conversion rate using the same web element action with parameter getValue. We need to provide the XPath of the result field. We also need to create a string variable rate to store the retrieved value. At the end, we will open the file again. Make sure to save the changes and paste the value saved in the variable rate in the cell below. Let's play the script to see if the bot performs all actions as required. The execution is complete. Now let's check the result. We can see that column B in our Excel file has been populated with currency rates as expected.